Audience, young and old, and welcome to our most spine-tingling of tales. Scream as the dead themselves rise from their unholy graves. Gasp at the astonishing special effects. Swoon at the plight of our beautiful heroines. Cheer at the bravery of our dashing heroes as they fight to save not only the women they love, but the entire world itself. Our story begins on a dark and stormy night in Transylvania.
Come back! Where does that blasted driver think he's off to? Is this the castle, then? I did not travel hundreds of miles across Europe to be abandoned in the middle of the night carrying my own suitcase. Honestly, this is just not the sort of treatment a respected London solicitor expects.
Jonathan Harker, I presume.
Yes. You must be Count Dracula.
Yes. Welcome to my beautiful Transylvania. Let me take your luggage. My servants are not available.
Most kind.
I have been looking forward to meeting you. Your firm writes most highly of your talents. They say you are a man of good taste, and that you're a worthy substitute for your predecessor, Mr. Renfield.
You may rely on me.
You must be hungry after your journey.
What an odd fellow. So pale looking, and what remarkable teeth.
Here.
Thank you. Will you join me in a glass of wine?
I don't think we both fit. Besides, I never drink wine.
Now this looks delicious. Healthy. All these lentils, peas, and beans.
Yes, I love all pulses. Would you like some fruit? I always like a nice juicy nectarine or some blood oranges before I rest.
No, thank you, Count. This is more than enough. Delicious, though I do usually hope to squeeze in a banana before the end of the day.
These Westerners, they have no morals. Please sleep as late as you like tomorrow. I must be away until dusk, but I look forward to hearing about the beautiful English estates you have found for me. Make yourself at home here. Go where you wish, except where the doors are locked. Remember, Transylvania is very different. Some things we do here may appear strange, but these are simply our ways. Try to respect them.
I've been rather looking forward to exploring the area.
You will not leave the castle. I would prefer it if you did not go out on your own. Wolves roam this region. It is not safe.
Of course, yes.
And no doubt you will wish to write some letters tomorrow to inform the necessary people of your arrival.
Yes, I must contact my firm, and Mina, of course, my fiancé. The most adorable creature. She worries terribly when I go away on business.
She is more than beautiful, Jonathan. She is perfect. Very tasty. I may be older than I once was, but I still have a healthy appetite for such creatures.
Yes, well, we are to be married in just a few months, and she's most excited. Gosh, the sun's coming up already. We've been up all night. I don't think I've done that since I was a student.
Then you must be frightfully tired. Come, let me show you to your room.
Yes, thank you.
Oh, Mina, I don't know which to choose. They're both so sweet and charming, and good-looking, and rich. but neither of them really rises up above the others as having the fuller wallet or trouser. Perhaps I could just have all three at the same time. Oh, Mina, I don't think you've heard a word I've said.
I'm sorry, Lucy. I haven't heard from Jonathan since he first arrived in Transylvania. It's not like him to leave so much time between letters.
Oh, but I'm sure he'll be fine. He's a big boy after all.
I'm just anxious for him to return so that we can be wed.
Oh, be patient, dear Mina. When it happens, it will be perfect. Tell me, what's it like to be so in love? I read about love and I see people who are in love, and sometimes I think I might be in love. Though I'm never quite sure who with. There's so many to choose from. But I know you're in love with Jonathan. If you'll tell me what it's like.
When I'm with Jonathan, I feel safe, protected. I can see us having a family, growing old together.
Oh, but what about the other aspects of love?
You mean?
What's he like in bed?
Hot milk with a dash of cinnamon, usually.
Oh, don't pretend you haven't thought about it.
Well, of course, but we've only been engaged for 5 years. It wouldn't be right. And there's more to a relationship than carnal pleasure.
Mina, you've got to have some fun with these men. Otherwise, there's no point in having them.
But Jonathan's so far away. I do hope he's all right.
This is a most bizarre experience. Up all night, asleep all day, the most peculiar host. No sign of any staff. Just a tray of breakfast left outside my room. And my coat appears to have been taken. Well, they certainly do things differently here. And they don't seem to have invented mirrors. I suppose the further you get from London, the more primitive everything becomes. If only Renfield hadn't gone mad, then he'd be here instead of me. And I'd be at home with Mina, planning the wedding.
Well?
Oh! Count Dracula! I thought I would have seen you come in my mirror.
Oh! Oh, Jonathan! You have caught yourself here.
I see you
wear a crucifix.
Don't worry, lots of people are squeamish at the sight of blood.
I am not squeamish. The people here simply do not approve of mirrors. The truth is not reflected in them. During your stay here, you shall grow a beard.
I don't think I'll be here long enough. Will I?
I think you might.
Well, perhaps we should start looking at some properties. Here is a beautiful estate near Exeter.
No. No, I want somewhere more historical, with culture, fine food, excellent amateur dramatics.
Well, how about Oxford? Or Cambridge?
Sadly, I am allergic to students. Do you have anything in Wales?
Wales? Oh no. It's full of gangs of tall, sinewy men who go about terrifying people with close harmony singing. And you'll need half a pint at least of phlegm to pronounce the place name. You'll be in danger of drowning every time you ask directions. Now this is rather special. Carfax Estate in Whitby. It's very old, incredibly large, and has an awfully pretty chapel.
Excellent! We nobles do so hate being near the bones of the common dead.
Nothing worse than embarrassing bones.
One would hate to find any skeletons in the closet. I wonder if there are others such as myself in the area.
Oh, it's very well to do. I know the family on the estate to the west, Mr. and Mrs. Westenra. They are most pleasant. Their daughter Lucy is a lovely young thing. She's friends with my Mina.
Really? Jonathan, I think I would like to purchase this estate.
I'll start drawing up the deeds.
And? You might want to write some additional letters. One stating that you are starting the work, another to say you are nearly finished, and a third to say you are getting ready to leave the castle.
Right. What date should I put on these letters?
Let me see. The 12th, the 19th, and the 29th of April.
I don't understand what's going on, and I don't like it. Why can't I write letters when I like, and why can't I send them myself? It makes no sense, and the Count gives no explanation. I must be bold and ask him. But I never seem to be able to say what I like when I'm with him. I feel as if I'm in a dream and can't quite control my thoughts. Now hang on! What's that outside the window? That man's wearing my coat! And I think that's one of my letters he's handing to a postman. Now why the devil won't the Count let me do that? And what in the devil's name? Good God! What are you doing to your cameras?
Oh, he's everything I hoped he would be!
So young and strong!
Kiss him, go on, kiss him!
Are you the maid? Perhaps not. Yes. Who are you?
We are yours.
You are ours!
We can all be lovers.
Now look here. I'm engaged to a lovely girl.
And lay your body down.
The rhythm of this trembling heart is
beating like a drum.
It beats for you.
It bleeds for you.
It knows not how it sounds.
For it is the drum of drums.
Oh, that tickles. Ow, biting. Ow, I'm not a piece of meat.
Oh, but you are.
Juicy meat.
Oh, bloody meat.
Back. Back, you foul fiends.
I only wanted to kiss him.
He's so young and pure.
Warm-blooded and juicy.
No! He is mine! When I am finished with him, then you shall have him.
But you yourself will never love.
You don't know how to love.
You're wrong! I, too, have loved and will love again!
Why have you not loved for so long?
300 years ago, I found the love of my life had been unfaithful to me with my best friend.
You beat her?
Yes, beat him too. Now, begone!
I've got to get out of here. I can't get out. The doors, they're all locked. No!
General Quincy Morris to see you, sir. General Quincy C. Morris is a military man. He just loves showing young ladies his weapon.
Lucy, you're practically indecent.
I just know what men desire. Watch and learn.
Lucy, my lovely young wench, I was hoping to speak with you in private. Lucy, I've been awfully fond of you for a very long time now, and I was thinking that maybe I could have you for my wife.
Well, your wife can't have me.
That wasn't what I meant. I simply meant that maybe I could...
Is that the doorbell?
Lucy, you look as fresh as the spring rain.
Oh, Jack.
And he's just as wet.
This is General Quincy Morris. He's just returned from Boston in America. Quincy, this is Dr. Jack Seward.
Boston? What state is that in?
terrible state, really.
Well, thought as much. It's a pleasure to meet you.
Likewise, I'm sure.
Lord Arthur Homewood.
Arthur! Arthur, I can't hear you.
Oh, Charlie Ho, what about your uncle?
Or as we say here on Earth, hello.
Oh, come and meet some of my friends. Oh, wait. Where did Mina go?
Who's that, miss?
Oh, my dear friend Mina. She's staying with me. She can be a little shy. Please excuse me while I check on her.
Tend to your friend.
Oh, such a sweet girl.
Oh, so caring.
And bald, bouncingly beautiful. Jack, Dr. A, impressive stuff.
Mm.
Maybe you could take a look at my knee. It's been giving me some jips since a rather unfortunate incident involving a weasel on a unicycle.
Well, actually, I'm a psychiatrist.
Oh, you spend your time with nutters?
Patients, and very interesting cases they are too. I have this one patient called Renfield, who used to be a solicitor, went away on business, a perfectly well-balanced man, and returned a month later with a healthy appetite for spiders and flies.
Oh, what caused that?
Well, my only guess is that something terrible happened to him while he was away on that business trip to Transylvania.
Sounds like he needs a good stint in the army to sort him out. Learning how to give a man a lethal blow, even when he's coming hard at you. Learning how to take the tackle face to face or to take a man from behind. There's nothing makes a man, a madman, sane, I should say, like giving the enemy a good roddering.
Well, an interesting approach, but not one I can see the medical profession adopting any time soon.
Would you like a smoke?
Boring idea! I have rather a good line in a rough shag if you're interested.
Would you do the honours?
Certainly, General. Always happy to fill the pipe of a military man. Doctor?
No, I don't, thanks.
You there, Becky?
Yes, my lord, although it's Betty.
Oh, fetch my cigar case, there's a dear.
Very well, sir.
Oh, she's a lovely young thing, isn't she?
Yeah, such a shame she's got housemaid's knee in both knees.
Oh, that's got to be pretty awkward for a housemaid.
Yes, but in my experience, knees apart, she's the greatest.
Here's your cigar case. And General Morris, you left your book in reception.
Thank you.
Hey, what's the title?
The Blimp-Wristed Brigadier General and His Enormously Bosomed Wife.
A philosophical work. Oh, Becky, my dear, give me a fortified wine, would you?
Yes, sir.
Oh, yeah, lovely. Oh,
marvellous, marvellous. Any port in a storm, eh? Crazy times.
Yes, it is a mad era.
Well, what a mess. I'm fed up with serving people who don't appreciate it. Last week, for example, they said they wanted a meal for 12. I asked if it would be sit down or buffet. There's down. So I get it all ready, and then at the last minute they change their minds, so I organise a buffet. Oh, the evening goes perfectly without a word of thanks, just a comment about how my napkins could have been softer.
They were a little starchy last time I felt them.
I mean, yes, ma'am.
Ow!
Oh, the poor dear.
He's still alive, but it looks like he's banged his head pretty badly.
We can't leave him here like this.
Then we must take him to Sister Maria. She'll know what to do.
There's no one who can solve a problem like Maria.
Oh, no! Show them your coins!
Bugger off, you pointed tooth gits!
Oh, shit!
Oh, look! Oh, well, you've brought another man home. Oh, they don't keep well as pets.
But Sister Maria, we couldn't just leave him. Nightfall was approaching.
Oh, well, I suppose he can stay here until he gets his strength back. I'll make some inquiries. Somebody must be missing him.
Where am I?
In a convent. We found you unconscious. I am Sister Sledge, this is Sister Act, and this is Sister Tended.
Sister Tended? There's no pun in that name.
Oh yes, there's no pun intended.
I'm Jonathan Harker. Sisters, I dread to think what could have happened if you had not found me.
Wolves?
I am on the run from an evil you could never imagine.
Lawyers?
Worse. I am a lawyer, and I'm scared.
Our mystery visitor is awake. I am Sister Maria.
I think I once knew a nun named Maria. She wasn't a very good nun. Too many filthy habits.
Oh, he's still delirious. Oh, well, you are welcome to stay here. Can we get you something to eat? Do you drink coffee?
I take tea, my dear. Oh, and I'd love some toast done on one side.
You can hear it in his accent when he talks.
He's an Englishman from New York.
How far have I come from Transylvania?
Oh, about 30 miles.
Oh, I hope that's far enough. I was lured out here under false pretenses. He said he needed a lawyer. Instead, he took me prisoner, let my demon women drink my blood, drain me.
Oh, but you've escaped now, Jonathan. You are strong, and God is with you.
But they might have followed me.
Do you think they noticed you leaving?
Everyone seemed busy preparing for something, like he was going somewhere. My God, he's going to England. In a week, he'll be walking the streets of Whitby. Oh, Mina, he knows what Mina looks like. He said she looked tasty. Good God, it's taken me this long to work out. What a mad, blundering, incredibly handsome young idiot I am.
Calm down, Jonathan, dear. Give me her address and I will invite her to join you here.
Thank you, Sister Maria. You don't seem too distressed by all this.
Well, believe it or not, these blood-sucking demons have been roaming the land for centuries. We've defeated some of them with holy water and crosses and Bibles. Oh, but we've never been able to get our hands on Count Dracula.
How did you escape, Jonathan?
Well, I found myself locked in a dimly lit room, and I remembered I had a book of matches in my back pocket. I got it out, and the packet said, to light match, strike on bottom. Well, after putting my trousers out, I decided to regroup and come up with a better plan. So I forced open the window, climbed down the ivy on the castle wall, and ran for it. I saw trees ahead of me, and the thought flashed through my head. Run, forest, run! I don't remember where I went. I just remember running and not looking back. I just hope they don't find us here.
If it makes you feel better, we're quite happy to go out and have a look around the area.
No, it's not safe out there. Please, Sister Sledge.
It's all right, Jonathan. I've got all my sisters with me.
Now remember, sisters, what are you to do if somebody accosts you with bad intentions?
We are to lift up our habits.
What? Oh, and then?
Tell him to drop his trousers.
Really? Oh, and then what?
Then we run away, as it's far easier to outrun him with our habits up and his trousers down.
Oh, yes, of course, sisters, you're quite right.
Rest here, Jonathan. We'll be back soon.
But I need a wimple.
Well, you should have gone earlier. Come on, there's no time.
Godspeed you, sisters. Oh, Mina, I hope the letter reaches you in time.
Captain's log of the Russian schooner Demeter, 27th May. We picked up the cargo bound for London, a strange array of large, heavy boxes, no passengers. We set sail just before noon, but have encountered a mighty Storm. 29th of May. Crew seem dissatisfied, almost scared. They will not say why. The storm rages as fiercely as ever. 3rd of June. Rosky has gone missing. The rest of the watch saw nothing. There are rumors among the crew that there is someone or something abroad. This is nothing but fear and imagination. 10th June. Algaron, my first mate, has seen something.
I did.
He saw.
I was on my watch and I was sheltering from the rainstorm behind the deck house when I saw a strange man. He passed along the deck. I followed him, but when I reached the bow.
Bow?
The pointy end, Captain.
When I reached it, there was no one in sight. There was something strange going on this ship, Captain. This is even worse than when that red ship and that brown ship collided last year in the Atlantic.
What happened?
Both crews were marooned!
Get out!
Oh, Captain's log. Aye. What are you doing up there, Seaman Staines? It's dangerous up there! Get down right now!
I've seen him. You can't save me from... But the sea can. The sea will save me.
Come down! Captain's log, supplemental. We'll find whatever it is and sort it. See it, say it, sort it. Who's with me? No, only me left. God help me. I must get this ship to shore.
Your tea and paper, miss. Miss, you look exhausted. Is everything all right?
Lucy was sleepwalking again last night. Twice I woke up and put her back to bed. But I shall be fine after I've had my tea. Tea cures everything.
Except syphilis.
I have a headache. Would you mind reading the headlines to me?
Certainly, miss. It was discovered today that the vessel that slammed into Tate Hill Pier in the early hours of yesterday morning was the Russian schooner Demeter.
Ooh, tell me more about that.
The police are still refusing entry onto the vessel, but it would appear that the vessel was completely without its crew, save for the captain. Dead for at least 2 days, who was found fastened by his hands to a spoke of the ship's tiller. Stranger yet, between his hand and the wood was a crucifix. But enough of that. And in the stock market, helium is up, feathers are down, paper is stationary. And the Queen Mother is ill. Oh, no, the Queen Mother is 111. And as for the weather...
Oh no, it's all so depressing. I'm just pleased Jonathan was not at sea. At least, I don't think he was.
Have you still not heard from Mr. Harker?
The firm's senior partner received a letter last week saying that Jonathan was almost completed his assignment. If anything comes for me from Transylvania, you must let me know immediately.
Of course, miss.
Oh, I love him. I love him. I love him. I love him. Oh, Mina, I really do love him. And I've said I'll marry him.
Let me guess. The general with the impressive weapon?
No. Lord Arthur Homeward will be Lord and Lady Homeward. Oh, how marvellous.
Didn't the general propose as well?
Yes, but he's mad as a bicycle.
And Dr. Seward?
Oh, Jack is absolutely lovely, but wetter than a fish's wet bits, I'm afraid. No, it's Arthur that I love, and Arthur that I have agreed to marry. Oh, Mina, you will help me plan the wedding, won't you? Oh, Mina, you could at least look happy for me.
I thought Jonathan and I would be married by now.
He'll be fine. He's just up to his neck in work. You know you can always count on him. Let's start looking for wedding dresses for the both of us.
Oh God, I can't stand it any longer. This place is enough to drive a man completely balmy.
I suppose.
The noise, the endless noise, the screams, the clanging doors, the clanking chains, the straitjackets. Moonstruck.
I'm sorry.
Well, lunatic isn't very polite. And some doctors believe that those being called by that word that I'd rather not use to describe those being called it are affected by the phases of the moon. So a better word for lunatic would be moonstruck.
Yes, well, the moonstruck asylum doesn't have quite the same ring.
Oh, come on, O'Connell. You've got 25 other lunatics to feed before the end of the shift.
Coming. Sorry, let's get back to work. Oh, hello, Dr. Stewart. Mad as a button, that one.
Ah, two visits in as many days. Am I becoming even more insane?
Oh, no, no. I just want to help you get to the bottom of your problems.
My problems? So it has nothing to do with the fact that the lovely Lucy Westenra refused your proposal, and so you've decided to thrill yourself into your work.
What an outrageous claim. How do you know Lucy refused me?
You lot think we're stupid as well as mad.
Well, I don't think you're stupid or mad.
Yes, you do. But it doesn't matter. We have ears. We hear what goes on. Anyway, I wouldn't wish a broken heart upon anyone. So if working with me eases the pain, then I consider your visits a pleasure. Right? Where had we got to last time?
Pigeons.
Yes. Have you thought any more about my request?
Well, I need to more understand the reasoning behind it.
I just want a pet pigeon.
Does it have to be any sort of pigeon? A carrier? Racing?
Just a pretty, feathery, plump-breasted, hungry pigeon.
Hungry?
Oh, yes, otherwise it won't eat the spiders.
The spiders?
The spiders that I've been keeping.
Weren't they your pets?
Well, yes, they are, but the pigeon will need something to eat.
But if I agree to the pigeon, I'll agree to some grain for the pigeon. It's only fair.
I'm not having my pigeon eating grain. It'll need lives, lots of lives. That's why I have the spiders ready. It's the circle of life, Doctor. I collected those flies and fed them to the spiders, and now I need a pigeon to eat the spiders.
And then what? Well, I might allow a pigeon, maybe even a cat, but how far are you going to take this? I'm not having a great dirty great big rhino parading around in my hospital.
Oh, it won't come to that, Doctor.
Well, how can it not if your aim is to follow through a food chain?
Well, that's not my aim. Keep trying, and by the time my food chain gets that far, I won't be in here anymore.
Oh, you seem very sure of that.
Every life belongs to another. It's inevitable. The lives of the flies belong to those spiders. Those spiders belong to the pigeon.
Your point is?
My life also belongs to someone. He will come for me soon. He needs my life and those of many others for his existence.
Did you join one of those cults that became so popular last year?
No, Doctor. I shan't warn you of his arrival. But he is coming for me. And when he does, he will give me the greatest gift a man could ever ask for.
His sister. Oh, no, one of those little knives with all those funny little attachments.
The blessing of immortality. But before he comes, I need more lives.
I'll go see about that pigeon. Did you just eat that fly?
What fly?
You just ate a fly.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did.
Well, even if I did, what can you do about it?
Well, take away your spider and refuse to give you a pigeon.
Oh, right. Well, I'm hardly going to eat a spider or a pigeon.
Well, I didn't expect you to eat flies.
I didn't eat the fly.
Yes, you... Never mind. We'll deal with this another time.
You're the doctor, Doctor. Come back, my pretty. I won't hurt you. I just want your life.
Lucy! Lucy! Oh, Lucy, wake up!
Oh, what's the matter?
I've heard from Jonathan. He's in the care of a group of nuns and wants me to go to him so we can be married.
Oh, that's fantastic.
Lucy?
The most bizarre dream, and now I feel completely drained.
I'll fetch Jack. Jack?
What seems to be the problem, dear Lucy?
I was fine when I went to bed.
No dry cough, no fever. Well, it will probably pass in a day.
Jack, she looks completely peaked.
Well, she's so pale that I could swear that she's lost a lot of blood, but I'm at a loss to diagnose the cause. I would like to send for my old friend and tutor, Professor Van Helsing. Well, she's a bit odd, but she's got a great knowledge of rare diseases, and she may be able to, determine the cause of this illness.
Oh, please do.
I don't like this, Arthur. I've never had great faith in the quack medical profession. I always hate the way they call what they do practice.
Jack will look after Lucy, my dear. He doesn't believe in unnecessary surgery. He'll only operate if he really doesn't need the money.
Now, I've sent a telegraph to Professor Van Helsing. She should be with us tomorrow. We're most fortunate. She normally works in Amsterdam, but by an amazing coincidence, she was giving a course of lectures at Tull University this week.
We're all here for you, Lucy.
Oh, but Mina, Jonathan needs you too. You really should go to him.
If you're sure, but you must let the boys take care of you.
I think we should let Lucy rest, and I should be getting back to the asylum.
Good night, my sweet.
Grenfell, what's all this commotion about?
The pigeon!
Oh, yes, the board have decided against it. They said the ethics of feeding one pet to another was not very, British.
Oh, thank you so much! It's the best present I've ever been given!
What is?
The pigeon! The pigeon!
I haven't got you a pigeon.
Well, yes, you have! Look!
Look, there's no pigeon, nor is there going to be. Now, you are clearly in no mood to communicate coherently, so I bid you a good night.
Hello? Hello? Oh, hello, hello, hello. Oh. What's your name?
Gerald.
I got your telegraph. I came as fast as I could. How's our patient?
Paler!
I've never seen her like this.
Paler than a toy standing stark naked in front of a herd of sex-starved cannibals.
Well, you're in safe hands now. This is Professor Abbey Van Helsing, a doctor of rare diseases as well as theology and philosophy.
What gynecology?
Oh, I didn't know you had your hand in that as well.
Thank you for coming, Professor.
Oh, my pleasure. Now, let's take a look at you. Interesting. A great deal of blood loss.
Yes, I noticed that, but I can't explain what caused it.
An aversion to bright lights.
Oh, Luke.
is an aristocrat. She has a delicate disposition. It's not uncommon for such lovely creatures to shy away from bright light.
Now, my dear, I want you to turn to your fiancé and stick out your tongue.
Why is that?
Because I don't like young Arthur's tone. I am the doctor, and he is mansplaining. You should trust me. Ah, what have we here? Three small marks upon her neck.
Three?
Two small marks upon her neck.
I noticed that. I thought she pricked herself penny a score. Is there something more?
Could be. Betty, get these for me.
Very well.
Gentlemen.
What is it, Professor?
I'm not certain.
But you have an idea.
Yes, and no.
Well, which is it, woman?
No, but I'm leaning towards yes.
So it's a yes, then?
No.
It must be a no, then.
Not necessarily.
Are you sure?
Perfectly.
What is it we're sure of?
Her theory of yes and no.
Gentlemen, we may be dealing with something supernatural. But I shall retire to the library to do some research first. I want one of you to be Miss Lucy and awake at all times!
We'll take shifts.
I'll cancel my next video conference and keep watch now.
I'll watch her while you dine.
I'll sit with her into the early hours.
I'll get up at 3 to relieve you.
That's funny, I normally get up at about 3 to relieve myself.
Back first thing in the morning. Ah, thank you, Betty. Now, everyone, take one of these garlic bulbs and place them around the patient. The garlic has a strong medicinal value.
Ew! But do we have to really cover the poor girl in all this horrible stuff?
Yes, you must! You absolutely must! The garlic will protect her. I will see you all in the morning. Stay with her at all times.
They're a lovely couple. I'm just so glad we got to her before the vampires.
Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today in the sight of the Lord to witness the union of two people who've been through so much and travelled so far. Jonathan, you have undergone such trials and tribulations, but the Lord has protected you. Where did you find this amazing strength?
Well, when I find myself in times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom.
Let it be!
And me. You have shown your love to Jonathan by travelling many miles to be with him. Now, do you take Jonathan to be your lawful wedded husband?
I do.
And Jonathan, do you take Wilhelmina to be your awful wedded wife?
I do.
Ah, yes, marvellous. Now, let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Harold?
Yes. Harold.
But it's hallowed be thy name.
Hallowed is not a name.
But it's not Harold.
Oh, heresy, heresy, there is a heretic in our presence.
Ha, she was only testing you, Father.
Yeah. Well, in that case, it is my honor to now pronounce her man and wife. You may kiss the bridge. Oh, the bride.
I love you so much.
Oh, John,
I love you, and I'm so thankful that the sisters found me and sent for me.
I dread to think what would have happened to me if they hadn't found me.
I wish you'd tell me what happened at that castle.
I only want to forget about it. I kept a diary, and though I assure you you don't want to read it, I shall give it to you later so you know there is nothing I would keep from you.
I can't wait to get back to England and tell Lucy we're married. Oh, Lucy. She was poorly when I left England. Jack even sent for a specialist doctor.
Well, I'm sure she'll be fighting fit by the time we get home.
Will Lucy be fighting fit? Will Dracula eat them all? Will anyone ever learn to read the auto cue properly? Tune in next week to find out. Same bat time, same bat place.